From Babylon to Timbuktu, epilogue. At the time that I am writing these pages, Reverend Ralph Abernathy is traveling around the country telling the American people, "I am going to Washington to tell the pharaohs to let my people go. As it was with the pharaohs of ancient Egypt, so it is unlikely that the leaders of Washington will concede to the demands of the Poor People's March. Considering all the rampant violence in the United States, there are many indications that the March on Washington will erupt into violence. The power structure concedes nothing without a demand. When the government refuses to effect reforms and to implement justice, the people lose respect for the institutions of law and order. Law and order without justice are worthless in a democracy. When peaceful demonstrations do not soften the attitude of the government, militant and vigorous tactics must be employed by the militants in order to prevail upon the government. These tactics sometimes come close to anarchy. At this tense point, a mass movement can travel in one of two directions. If the government concedes to the demands of the people, all well and good. The mass movement falls apart because it has accomplished its objective. On the other hand, if the government refuses the demands of the mass movement, it generally downpresses the rebellion of civil disobedience. When the people continue to rebel, and the government continues to downpress, this condition leads to fascism and a dictatorship. There follows mass murder, which is committed in the name of law and order. Dr. Martin Luther King expressed these thoughts before he was assassinated. If the conditions do not change soon in this country, we will have a fascist police state in the 1970s. I do not think that America has the moral strength and will to resolve her racial problem and to avert a fascist takeover. But if rapid collective constructive action is taken immediately, we can save the American cities from disaster. If a police state is established in America, this will fulfill the prophecy of Daniel. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince, which standeth for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation even to that same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book." Daniel chapter 12 verse 1.